Hi everyone, this is Amit, and in this video I'll be showing you how GSTR1 return can be filed in very simple manner and what are the tables that needs to be filled by the taxpayer. Basically there are many tables, but it's not that all tables are relevant to you. There can be the chances where you are doing transaction on B2B basis, like business to business, or even it can happen you are just exporting your goods. So you don't have to fill the complete form, you just have to fill the relevant details where you are eligible. So let's see how it works. So once you log in, you have to navigate to services, returns, return dashboard, and then you can select the financial year, quarter, period, and then you can click on search button. So you can see below are the tables which will be getting shown to you. So that is GSTR1, which is where you need to add your invoice details. 2A, which is auto populated on the basis of what entries has been done by the supplier to you. So let's see for GSTR1 how it works. You just have to click on prepare online or offline. If you have to file through Excel, if you have multiple invoices, you can just go to prepare offline. You can download the template, fill the invoice, and you can just submit it. And if there are less number of invoices, you can just go and click on prepare online. So once you click on prepare online, some details will be auto populated, like GST and legal name, the status is not filed, and the due date is 11th of December. So we have enough time, but still for creating the video, I'm showing you how it works. So this is the first table, which is B2B, which comes under 4A, 4B, 4C, 6B, 6C. So whatever options, like order invoice details are there, you can just click and you can just fill it over here. So it's very simple, guys. You can see, like, I'll be not doing anything which system will be not telling me. I will just going through the system. So I came here. So now what system is telling? There are no invoices. Okay, it's blank now. Now what I have to do? I have to add the details. So yeah, I got this button. I'll click on add details. So following are the options which will be shown to the taxpayer. So let's say you can see some of the fields are already disabled. That means you are not eligible for that. You are not SEZ user, so it is disabled. So system has already locked it. That is good. So if you are doing deemed export, you can select this. If you are not doing, you can just ignore it. Let's say if you are doing the transaction where reverse charge is there, means that liability will be paid by the person to whom the goods has been sold. So you can just go and you can select reverse charge. Then let's say if you are doing this business within state, then it will be intra. If you are doing outside the state, it will be inter. So that fields are auto populated. You don't have to worry about it. So only what you have to do is you can enter the GSTN of the persons against which you have done the business. So let's say I have entered the GSTN and click on tab button. So what it is showing? It is showing to enter a registered GSTN. So this is invalid, so it will show invalid message. The system will verify everything. You don't have to worry, you just have to enter the proper GSTN. So let's correct it now. So now I'll be using the correct GSTN. So I just copied and pasted it. So you can see system is auto populated all the details, the receiver name, then the place of supply, it's by default Maharashtra. Now what you can do, you can just add the invoice number. Let's say invoice number is 01, you added over here. The invoice date you can enter, it's for 6th of November. What is the invoice value? Let's say it's 50,000. So I added, and it's within the Maharashtra, so by default it has taken as intrastate. Now these are the basic slabs which you need to understand and you need to fill. Like what business you have did, and on the what rate the government allow you to make the business. That you have to check and you have to fill it over here. So what I did, I have sold the papers to the Build Graphic Paper Products. He's the receiver and I am the supplier. So the tax what government is asking is 18%. So what I'll be doing, I will just coming here, I will be entering the taxable value. So the complete taxable value is 45,000 out of 50,000. The system has generated like CGST and SGST, that is 50-50% distributed. So it will be coming as 4050, 4050. That is 8,100 rupees. That is 18% of 45,000. So that's it. And if there is any cess value, you can just add over here manually. So once you have added, you don't have to do anything. You just have to save here. And if you want to go back, you can click on back button. Now what I am doing, I am just saving it. So my request accepted successfully. Now you can see the invoice got added over here. And if you want to add much more details, then more invoices, you can just click on add details and you can follow the same process for different invoices. So that's it guys. This is the step for adding the invoices in B2B table. So now what I will be doing, I'll be just going back. Back. Now as you can see, the count is not displayed on this table as of now. Why? Because you added the entry, but we have not generated the summary. So once you fill the entry, you have to generate the summary. So the count will be shown on the top of the tile. And if you want to see what invoices we can add this in this tile, so you can just take the mouse pointer on this and it will show you taxable outward supplies made to registered person, and that is including UIN. So that entries you have to make over here, and then you have to just file the return. That's it guys. This is a simple process. And let's say if you want to add another invoices, like if you have done business with the persons who are last taxpayer and who are not registered, like business to customer. So you can just do the mouse hovering and you can see like on the screen message is shown. It's not shown in proper format. There might be some kind of defect, but the purpose is the taxable outward supply to unregistered person, where place of supply is another than state where supply is located. Means you are in Maharashtra, you are doing business in another state and the value is more than 2.5 lakhs. So what you can do, you can just come here, same way, you can click on it, you can add details and you can save it. So this is all simple process. You just have to understand what tile you need to fill. So this is second tile. So you can see the invoices which I have added, the count is shown over here. It takes 5 to 10 seconds and it displays the count on the screen itself, along with the complete summary. You can see the total value, taxable value and the liability what you need to pay. You don't have to do anything on this. And let's say if you have any credit debit notes against that particular invoice, you can just go to this tile, you can click on this, and similar way how you added invoice over there, you can just click on add details button. See, you can just enter the receiver's GSTN, the debit number, credit note number, date, POS and save. That's it, a very simple option. Even I don't have to fill it. I think it's more than enough to so that anyone can understand how to file return. Same, these are like for unregistered. One is for export. If you are exporting, it will be shown or you can add it over here. If you want to amend B2B invoices, what you have filed in the previous month, you can amend over here. Let's say if you want to amend export invoices, you can just add it over here. If you want to amend credit debit notes, you can add it over here. These are the only tiles which you need to take your mouse pointer over there and complete details will be shown to you. Let's say if any other details are there, you can go to 7th table, that is B2C others. If nil rated supplies are dead, you can go to this table. If advance received is there, you have to make the entry. You can go to 11A, 11A, 1 and 2, this table. And if you want to enter HSNY summary, you can go to this table. If you want to add the documents which which got issued at the time of like doing business, you can add over here so that the officer will clearly understand from the documents. And if you want to adjust the advance, you can just click on here. If you want to amend B2C, this is the option. These are the tiles which you just need to fill and you have to submit. That's it guys. This is the way to file the return. Now what I will be doing, let's say you have completed all the tables, you have filled the details wherever required. Then you can click on generate GSTR1 summary button. So once you have filled the invoice details, now you can click on generate summary button. Once you click on this, it will be taking some time and all the summary will be generated on your tiles. Like here for first one invoice what you added, it is coming one. Let's say if you added another invoice in another tables, the count will be shown on the screen. Like as of now it is zero, the tile will be showing the actual count. But for me it is only one invoice what I have did business in this month, so I'll just filling one. Now what I'll be doing, I can just, if you want, you can just download the history from here. So As of now, it's a no file, and this is e-invoice related history. If you have added any details in e-invoice portal, then only it will come. But there is no entry I have made for e-invoice, so I'll just ignore it. And let's say even if there is entries made in EVA bill data, in EVA bill portal. So if you want to import it, you can just click on this. And it will be showing for current tax period, there is no EVA bill invoices. If it is available in EVA bill portal, it will be auto-populated over here. Even you don't have to make this entry manually. So this is the simple process how you can just file the return. You don't have to go to CA, or you don't have to go to any person who is charging you for filing the returns. What you can do, if you want, you can just reset it. Once you reset, all tabs will be getting zero. Or if you want to check, you can just click on preview button. So once you click on preview button, the all PDF will be getting generated along with the GST and legal name, what entries you have made, like it was total invoice 50,000, total tax, and for the other tables you have not filled, so it is zero. If you want, you can just fill it. And if you want me to fill, you just comment and let me know that these details you need to fill. I'll just try to make the video for that. So that's it, guys. Now what you can do, you can click on this checkbox acknowledging the what details you have filled is correct. You can click on submit button. It will be showing you are about to submit GSTR1. Would you like to proceed? No changes can be made in the return after submitting. Once you click on proceed button, I think the summary hasn't got generated, so it will take some time. So we'll wait for that. We'll try one more time. Now it is not showing any error message. We'll go at the bottom, select the checkbox, click on submit button. So you can see again, I have got the error. What is the error? You cannot submit GSTR1 for this return period. Why this error is coming? Because I am trying to file the return for the month of November and it's not completed now. That's why system is not allowing me to file the return. The same process, if I follow next month, it will allow me to file the return and I'll be getting the EVC, and just I can just submit it. Once I submit, the status will be changed to file. That's it, guys. This is the process of filing GSTR1, which is very simple. You can just see the video and you can just file your return. So thanks for watching the video. Do like the video and subscribe the channel for the motivation and for the updates on the GST. Thank you, guys.